So, Love Bone, you stated earlier that it was a man that you had met, and he had everything together, and you were saying that you could see yourself being a sister wife in that situation.
Uh-huh.
Right?
But I mean, yeah, that was before she took a... You see that? How, you see that glass bottle over there, Kadar? That was before she was sipping in that glass bottle. Pay attention, huh?
It's tea.
Yeah, of course it's tea.
It's peach brown tea. Like
that. That tea got something in it, man.
What's your question about that?
No, I'm saying like you stated that earlier, but then now it's like a different answer.
No. So to your point, so that couple and I are friends, okay? He has no interest, but when I see him, I have thought those thoughts before, like, wow, if I ever did participate, I could do that with him. But just in general thought, no, I don't see anything wrong with it. I see the benefits of it, but I think I've lived my life so long the way that it is. I don't want to spend the rest of my life trying to mentally adapt to that. No.
So what was it that you saw that gave you that wow factor mentally?
With the man? He's an honorable man. He's a beautiful man to look at. And he carries himself with a lot of integrity. He's an innovator too. Like him and his wife, I've known them for 20 plus years, and I've just seen the constant just elevation. They're always on elevation together, you know. I've seen them get healthy together. I've seen them improve their finances together. You know, they're always pushing the envelope. Mm-hmm.
And that's pretty much what we're explaining on this side. So, and then just to put one thing out there, like any man that you deal with is going to be polygamous. It's in their nature. So would you rather deal with a man that's going to do it and tell you lies, or a man that's going to be upfront and righteous with it? That's the question.
I hear what you're saying, but I do think that there are men out there that lifestyle is not appealing to them. I know men that want one woman.
At least that's what they tell you.
It's so funny. I think I get what you're saying. Who wouldn't want to have access and the option? But you're talking about doing it in honor, or are you talking about natural lust attraction?
Naturally,
or you're talking about betting?
Naturally lust. Men are going to want more than one woman eventually. I don't care how beautiful you are. I don't care if you have an hourglass shape, you have an onion butt. That man, eventually, he's going to get tired of hitting that. But it's just a fact.
So let's go back. But let's deal with that. Let's stop there for a moment, because you said the men on this channel is about honor and integrity.
You just asked me, was it born out of lust, right?
Yeah.
The men on this channel decide to do it in an honorable way.
Okay.
You
know,
let me finish. But I'm telling you, it's in the nature of every man. Any man that says he's going to, the man that you think you're going to be with, that's going to look you in the eyes and tell you, I'm going to be with just you, is lying. Unless that man, you got him on those blue pills and they stop working. Now, that's the only way he's going to be with just you. Because, it's just in a man's nature. I don't care how much. It doesn't mean he doesn't love you, but it's in his nature to want. It's just the nature of a man to want to be with more than just one woman. Mm-hmm. It's just his nature to have that thrill, that chase. That's in his nature. That's the nature of a man. And any woman that, you know, believes that, some men are telling, nah, man, you can't. I had to talk with these guys. Nah, man, speak for yourself, man. He's a sucker. Now, let me tell you something. When I was in the world, that's the kind of man chick that I was screwing. I used to bang his chick out. Those kind of dudes that think like that, that because the women are always more attracted to the bad boy. And the reason that the women are more attracted to the bad boy, because he comes off as dominant, as, you know, charismatic, as not, I don't give a F attitude. And it's something about that that attracts women. And I'm going to tell you something. Attraction is not a choice. It's not a choice. When you're attracted to someone, the only way to prevent that is you can't be around them. You can't be around them. Because if you're around them long enough, the attraction will take place and it's going to take its effect straight up and down. And so most of the men that think like that anyways is men that's been indoctrinated with a feminist mindset, because they've been taught that it's wrong. They've been taught that it's wrong to do that. But it's in his nature. And when a man does that, I guarantee you, love only. In the background, that man's watching a lot of porn. He'll go and watch strippers. I've never been to a strip club. To me, suckers do that. What the hell am I going to go to a club with naked women dancing around if I'm not getting busy? Nah, I'm good on that. I've never been to, suckers do stuff like that. I wouldn't go to a strip club and get the real woman. I'm not going to a strip club and throw money around. That would feel as though I'm lowering my integrity. But a lot of guys do it. I always trying to figure out, well, what the hell they get out of this? You know, you get out of this. He's going home with a boner, man. Crosstown.
Yeah, it used to be Sears Robots.
There you go.
Yeah, but I don't think that's the name of the school. Is that the name of the school, Maurice?
Let's see. It's a school inside of that building. I don't know the name of it.
That's it, Crosstown. He says Crosstown.
Yep, it's Crosstown High School.
Yeah, right.
I just Googled.
Yep. Had a really good studio in there.
Mm-hmm. Did you go to the record room?
It's in the Sears building. No, we went into the studio. Like, his brother, I guess, was the instructor there.
Gotcha.
Yeah. But then I went to another studio over there. It was in the hood, though. That's where Champ was.
Have you gone back?
No, not yet. Yeah, we went back. We went back at the Sukkot. Right, Kadora, we stopped there at the Sukkot. So that was... What was that? October. Yeah, we was there in October.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Went to a different studio, though, with Champ. This guy named Champ.
You got to let me know when you're here so I can treat you to lunch, and you'll understand when you meet me, you'll understand why someone will spend their coins and take me out.
Damn.